most certainly without form and void, and yes, there was darkness upon the face of the deep, but the Spirit of God is most assuredly moving upon the face of these waters. Welcome. Welcome to the dark recesses of the cesspit. That is the New South Wales Central Coast, my brothers and sisters. It is getting truly, truly just beyond comprehension what is going on here right now. People are walking around everywhere in face masks. I just saw a lady at the park with her husband in her 60s going for her Sunday morning walk with a face mask. They've just brought in a rule, I believe, where whenever you go out, you must have a face mask. People are getting the demon juice. The whole world is wearing roller skates, but we here in the body of Christ, we just look on in just total and utter bewilderment as the world just loses its collective mind. It's an amazing time. We're pretty much under a police state here now. We've got policemen guarding entry and exits of freeways to ensure you don't go too far from your house, and all of these rules, and the police have got all of these extra powers. And if that's not a police state, they basically make it illegal to go and see your mum and dad. So if that's not a police state, I don't know what is. So a bit of a different type of video today, but I'll get back to that in just a sec. As I put down this video, Sunday, the 18th of July, 2021. It's about 11 o'clock in the morning here on the New South Wales Central Coast. It is a Sunday, and I am up to Matthew 22. And I just want to share this, what I just read in Matthew 21, 1. And when they drew nigh unto Jerusalem and were come to Bethphage, unto the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples. So remembering that Bethphage means house of unripe figs, and I'm being led to think that's the scene of the fig tree in Revelation 6:13. The untimely figs were the Pharisees. And this for me is saying that Bethphage is potentially the Mount of Olives. It could well pertain to the same place. So Bethphage is the house of unripe figs, and that's at the Mount of Olives. The Mount of Olives, and there's something significant about the Mount of Olives. The Mount of Olives, of course, being on the west side, for memory, of the Brook Kidron. The Brook Kidron. And the Brook Kidron is where they cast all the filth and dead animals into the city. And the other side of the Brook Kidron is the Mount of Olives. And that seems to be Bethphage, house of the unripe figs, where I'm being led to think the fig tree casts her untimely figs, being the Pharisees, in Mark 11. So what could this mean? Because I do wonder now what the fig tree is. If the figs are the stars of heaven, as it says in Revelation 6, what's the actual fig tree? What are the fig tree, right? But in any case, the point of today's video is what's happened is, because we're in this police state, this state that they call a lockdown, I'm finding now in these videos I'm being a lot more productive. I'm getting a lot more done because I've got a lot more time on my hands, and I'm finding I'm getting a lot done. So a couple of things. Expect the videos. I sort of want to put it out there that my expectation right now is that the videos will be coming out at a more rapid rate. I will be doing them a lot quicker, potentially every 2 to 3 days, maybe. It just depends. Each video, you have your own, it's its own event, each video, and you have your own set of issues with it. For example, yesterday the power went out and I lost 4 hours work. Things can happen. You have IT issues. Things might happen in the video. I have a lost file video. Anything can happen, right? Anything can happen. But I'm finding now I want to have that out there, that it's my expectation, right? So if the main channel does go quiet, it's not by my hands. I want to put that out there, right? So what I'm also finding is at the moment, it's a very, very fluid and live event that's happening here on the New South Wales Central Coast. And I'm finding in my videos, I'm sharing a lot of testimonies that pertain to that time. It pertains to that time where things are going on in the moment. And by the time the video comes out, because these are the videos I've got ready to go, right? These three videos right now are sitting here ready to roll. And what I'm going to do is my time is biblical time as Planet Babylon time. That's going to be up before I do this video. And then I'm going to upload that this video, and then those two will be uploaded after that. So those three videos, normally it will take me a week to get up, because I don't want to have just one video after another. I don't want to flood it, and I just don't want to, my videos are an hour and a half long, and I don't want to just go bang, bang, bang and get them out, right? But I want them out. I want these videos out, so when I share testimony, it's in the moment. I'm finding it's in the moment, and by the time the video comes out, things have moved here. Things have moved, and this is a diary, and I'm a witness. Something coming in hard right now is part of the purpose as to why the body of Christ is here, is to be a witness to these things. And I want to be a witness to the body of Christ, my precious brothers and sisters, who I'm blessed enough to have here on the channel. I want to be that witness, and I want to share what I'm seeing, some testimonies, and my story here on the New South Wales Central Coast in the moment, right? But I'm finding it impossible because I've got this backlog. I've just got this backlog up. So the point, what I'm trying to get to here, what I'm saying is the plan is today, I'm going to do a video. I shared a testimony yesterday, which as I go on has become quite a powerful testimony, just with a couple of things that happened during that video. So what I'm going to do today is I'm actually going to play a part of the video I'm currently working on. So it's the fourth one on from now. It's the one that's going to be here, right? It's the one that I'm currently working on. Now, when I release that video, this file that I'm going to share today will be on that video. I'm going to keep it on, but I want that testimony out now. And when I thought that last night, I thought, no, I really need to take care of this. I need to take care of this. I've got two things really on my mind right now that I've got these three videos. So what I will be doing is after I post the time video, I'm going to do that today. So by the time this is up, that'll be up. And then I'm going to post this one. And then the day after, I'm going to post the singing voices one. And then the day after that, I'm gonna post this one, and potentially the day after that, the one I'm working on now, because it should be ready, right? It should be ready by then, because I'm confident, because I've just got a lot more time now to work on all of these videos. Now, the other thing that's on my mind is because I'm speaking quite openly in these videos about what I'm seeing. I'm not carrying on silly, but I am speaking openly. And one thing that I do know is that there's no justice on the earth today, and what they call good on the earth today is actually evil, and what they call evil is pretty much good. Everything's upside down. So one thing that I've had a good relationship with YouTube, don't get me wrong, I've had a decent relationship with them, but I know the scene and I pretty much know the score of what's going on, like we all do right now, right? So I don't want to try to decipher their rules. I'm not interested. I'm more interested in the laws of God and the laws of the Lord Jesus Christ, right? I'm not overly interested in YouTube's rules, and I'm even less interested in the Templar Mason rules that they're inflicting here on the New South Wales Central Coast. So I'm just going to keep going and just keep being brave in the truth and just keep talking the way I talk in those videos, right? But I want to put it out there. Now, I'm not saying here for a minute, I'm not trying to get other people to, like more people to subs to my channels. I'm not about that. To me, if I have one brother or sister that's sharing my walk with me, I feel blessed, right? I feel blessed. For me, it's just whoever the Holy Spirit brings forward, I'm blessed enough to have them share my walk, right? So I'm not doing this today to get an increase in numbers to my channels, not at all. But in saying that, I want to put it out there that I do have two other channels. I've got this one and I've got this one. This one I don't really post on that much. This is like the third one, and I haven't posted on this one for about a year now. Pretty much a year since I posted on this one. And I was posting on this one because I had a strike. Last year I had a strike on the main channel, so I created this third one, right? Because I've got the second one. What I use the second one for is for my water test videos. So when I use a song, and I'm not sure whether I'm going to get a copyright infringement, and my New World Order Day 1 video, videos like that that I feel perhaps could attract attention, I use this second channel. I use this second channel. Now, when I had that strike last year, I was using this as the main channel, so this one became the water test channel, right? So that's what this one here is for. This one's here just for an emergency, right? Where this one I actually do use. Now, the point of the story is if my main channel does go quiet, it's not by my hands. It's not by my hands. So I will be posting on this one. I will leave links to both channels at the bottom of this video. So that's that, right? That's that. So as I say, I've been sharing testimonies on my videos, and I've got this backlog of videos that I just want to get out, right? So that's the plan. I'm going to post my time video. That'll be up by the time this one comes up. And then I'm going to post this one, whatever I might call it, probably from the depths of the sea or something like that it might be called. Hello from the depths of the sea, something of the like. And then I'll post my singing voices. And this is what I'm talking about now. I'm talking about the mark of the beast. So I'm going to get those ones out quite quickly because I just want everything now to be current. I want my videos to be current. And also when I get a comment from a brother or sister, because I'm speaking about a video I processed three or four videos ago, it's difficult to know. It's not fresh anymore in my mind. So I'm finding the fellowship is getting... I find I've got a hindrance. I've got something between me and my brothers and sisters as I fellowship, right? Because it's not fresh. So I want to be talking about the last video that I did. And it looks like we've got a lawnmower, but we will just plow through. So today, as I say, I'm going to share this video. I was talking about Revelation 13 and the mark of the beast. And I was looking at this word, overcome, because in Revelation 13, we read in verse 7 that the beast is going to make war with the saints and overcome them. So I find that a fascinating piece of scripture. The beast is going to overcome the saints in this war. So given what's happening here on the New South Wales Central Coast in this police state, I've been absolutely led back to these scriptures in Revelation, and this then led me to share a testimony that I just want out right now. And because I've got it on my mind and my heart as well about this backlog of videos, I thought, you know what, I might just kill the two birds with one stone, as it were. So that's the point of this video today, right? So this video that I'm about to play, this file, it'll just stop suddenly. It will just stop suddenly, but it is a part of a video that's going to continue. It's not a lost file or anything like that. It's just about a 25, half an hour maybe segment of the video I'm currently working on, but it'll be absolutely in that video again. So in around four videos time, if I'm blessed enough for you to watch both and my voice is going, that's better. If I'm blessed enough for you to watch both videos, You'll notice that you've seen it all before, right? So this lawnmower is not going away. neither is the madness, neither is the Stasi, neither are the brown shirts. So from here, from an absolutely lost its mind New South Wales Central Coast, I shall play the file. So who are the saints? Are the saints, are they the Hebrews? Are they the saints? Are the saints the Hebrews? And are all the saints in the 144,000? Or are there some saints who aren't in the 144,000? And are there all the saints are in the body of Christ, right? All the saints would be in the body of Christ. So there's no saints outside of the body of Christ. So if all are in the body of Christ, are they all saints? Are the saints the 144,000? These are the questions, right? These are the questions. They're very, very exciting questions. And I feel, not only because I've been talking about musicians and Moses and harps and the like, not only that, but because of my testimony right now, what's going on here on the New South Wales Central Coast, that I've been led back here again to talk about those things. It's marvellous. It's marvellous. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and overcome them. And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. So this is interesting as well, because the beast here is going to overcome the saints. He's going to overcome them. So that does that pertain to us today? If we're the saints, if the body of Christ is the saints, are they? Because if the beast is going to overcome the saints, well, does that mean the saints have prevailed over the beast? Because he's going to overcome them. So what does overcome mean? What does overcome mean? Right? So we'll have a look at the word overcome. It's Greek word G3528. We see it the 28 times. Overcome, conquer, prevail, get the victory. To conquer, to carry off the victory, come off victorious. Of Christ, victorious over all his foes, right? So that's this word here. That's this word here. So the beast is going to overcome the saints. He's going to overcome them. And this word's being used of Christians that hold fast their faith, even unto death, against the power of their foes and temptations and persecutions. When one is arraigned or goes to law to win the case, maintain one's case. So it's to be victorious. And when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him. I have overcome the world. So it's talking about the Lord Jesus Christ. Be not overcome with evil. So it's victorious. It's absolutely being victorious. And here in Revelation 13, this beast, he's going to make war with the saints and he's going to conquer them. Be victorious. So what could this mean and who could this be pertaining to? And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him. And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. So this is that separation that I'm talking about again. So I read this, and for me, it's a point of difference that if you're worshipping the beast, you are not written in this book of life. So when I read the rest of Revelation 13, I'm being led to think that that's defined by the mark of the beast. That's defined by the mark of the beast. So the scriptures are leading me to think that if you're at the end, which I'm absolutely seeing potentially that we are, if you're at the end and you take the mark of the beast, you're not written in the book of life. And to me, I'm pretty confident that we all of us already know that. So it's a point of difference. So if we're in these last times, these final events, which to me it seems that we could well be, as I go on and on, it's getting willing here on the New South Wales Central Coast. It's just getting next level every day. They keep finding more of these cases, and they're just pretend numbers, but it seems we're getting hundreds of cases every day. I've just seen an article, because I'm watching this now, as I put down this part of this video, it's July 17 now, and it's about 10 o'clock in the morning, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock in the morning, and it's a Saturday here on the New South Wales Central Coast. And I've just seen a news article where the head of the CSIRO, there's something to do with health or something here in Australia, they're calling for a tougher lockdown, and otherwise this outbreak will be out of control. And I'd like to see that. I want to see what out of control actually looks like, because there sure ain't any evidence of any boogie happening still. There's no evidence. I'm seeing no, it's the healthiest I've seen the Central Coast in all my life. There's no one sick. I can't remember the last time I saw anybody ill. It could be that they're staying at home because they're petrified. They're petrified of people seeing them. But I'm not. Normally you hear the little ones. During winter, you hear the little ones. They get that really throaty cough that the little ones get. You think, oh, you've got your first real cold there, little one, right? I'm not hearing that at all. I'm not hearing little ones with sniffles. I'm not hearing people coughing, sneezing. I'm not hearing any of it. I'm not seeing any manifestation of this at all. It's long settled, right? It's long settled that it's not true, but this doesn't mean that people aren't going to start dying, because that's what they've got now. They've got a license. They've absolutely just got an open license now that people are going to perish, and they can just blame it on the boogie and people are just going to believe it, right? So what does out of control actually look like? Because it's either they program us, so either we're going to get tough, because we're in what they call this lockdown, right? And it's very, very strict here. It's very strict. And I've got to be very, very, how do I say, smart and shrewd with the decisions I make. Mum made the analogy there yesterday, so I was trying to explain it to Mum that, yeah, we're brave. We're brave in the truth, but we've still got to make good decisions. And Mum said, yeah, she says, you can't tie yourself to the train tracks and ask God to save you, right? I said, perfect, Mum. That's absolutely perfect. So we've still got to make good decisions, right? And I don't, how can they get any tougher here? But they can. And to me, they've inflicted this upon everybody, but the case numbers continue to go up, so it's not working, right? So it's pretty obvious what's going to happen. They're going to create new stories out of nothing, where they're going to blame some rogue people and they're responsible for it because they're not following the rules. So because they haven't followed the rules, now we need to be tougher. The rules would work if you just follow them, right? And people aren't following them. They're going to make up these stories. And I see everybody around here are following them. I'm not. I just went down to a coffee shop here and I call it the Tower of Nonsense. You walk into these shops now and you're greeted with the Tower of Nonsense. It's just sitting there. You've got this beeping code thing and the hand sanitizer standing there and it's got all these rules written on. I just walk straight past it. I just walk straight past it, you know. The Tower of Nonsense. But Pete, I saw another guy after me. He walks in and I'm not judging him at all, right? Because he hasn't been blessed. He hasn't been woken up like we have. And to me, I'm like, well, how would I be behaving? How would I be behaving if I wasn't awake? I was praying about that very thing today, and I know I'd be angry. I would be rancid right now, and I'd be drinking, and I would be angry. I would be absolutely furious right now with what's going on, and I don't feel one shred of anger. How good's that, right? Not one shred of anger. I'm perplexed in a way, but not perplexed in another. It all has to be, right? It all has to be. But you can't help but be anxious. You can't help be anxious because of these scriptures that I'm about to go through in Revelation, because I'm seeing in another chapter later on in Revelation where we read about this beheading, and I'm seeing potentially that this could pertain to this overcoming them And it's indeed made me nervous about what could be coming for us, because it's all in Scripture and it's all a part of overcoming the mark of the beast. It's made me quite nervous, and I'm going to go through, it's the plan anyway, to go through these scriptures in just a sec. So I want to share just a quick, I'll call it a testimony, of just something that I've seen the last couple of days. So I went down to see Mum and Dad yesterday, and I try to get down there at least once a week, because I basically can't go and have cuppas with Mum anymore like I did at the shops. You just can't do it. It's not a matter of being afraid of them. It's like you can't tie yourself to the train tracks and ask God to save you, right? They've said it's illegal to go and do these things, and you literally cannot sit down. There's no chairs. You can't go and sit down, and they've got security guards at those shopping centres who are hurrying people along. They're hurrying people along. They won't let pensioners sit down, and all of these security staff, all of these police officers, they're very, very good at keeping people safe. They're doing their job with a great deal of relish and a great deal of enthusiasm, and the passion they feel to keep us safe is just overwhelming, and I feel so very blessed. So when I go to the shops, I know there's going to be people there itching to keep me safe, and it's not the place for me, right? So I don't go there. I'm not going to these places, and I'm very, very limited right now with what I can do. But what I've seen, I've got a Bible verse today. I'll just go grab it. It comes from Proverbs 20. So it's in the big calendar. It's in the big calendar that Mum gave me. So Saturday, the July 17, 2021. I can't look at the Sunday one. This is the only Bible verse I get on a Sunday, because the small calendar from Mum and the Psalm calendar from Mum, They've only got the one for the weekend. I don't know why they do that. You only get the one scripture for the weekend, but this one you get the two. So I've got to make sure I don't look at the bottom one, right? I can't look at the bottom one. So I'm going to cover it right as I read this out. But it comes from Proverbs 20:22. Say not thou, I will recompense. Now I've had a look at that word recompense, and it seems to pertain to be at peace with, to be at one with. You're cleaving yourself. It's a recompense. Say not thou, I will recompense evil, but wait on the Lord, and he shall save thee. Right? So that's the message. That's the message that I'm getting right now, is so don't recompense evil. So for me, I look at that and I think, well, I'm certainly not at peace with evil, but I don't want to participate in it either. And there's another scripture I remember from Proverbs where it says the wise man hides himself in the day of, and the fool goes out and about and to the like. I'll put it up on the screen. And right now I'm just thinking to myself, I need to be patient. I just need to wait on the Lord. And I'm still doing what I need to do. Whenever I need to go to the shops, I walk in and I don't participate in that nonsense and just act normally. But I'm not going out looking. I only do things if I absolutely need to, because I want to get to the end of this without having any contact with anybody whatsoever. I was saying to someone there the other day that my main two priorities, these aren't my priorities, right? But this is what I tell the world. My priority is to keep finding the Holy Spirit, keep seeking the Holy Spirit's face, and to continue to grow in this gospel, and to edify my brothers and sisters that come forward on this channel, and that I'm so blessed to have watched, and also be led by the Spirit as I go about my day-to-day life. They're my main priorities in life now, right? But when I speak to people who haven't been led to witness the truth to, I say to them my main two priorities, and these are my fleshly priorities right now, is that I don't want to be arrested, and I don't want to be identified with what they call a hotspot. I don't want to be identified, right? So I'm laying very, very low, right? So waiting on the Lord, and I feel that's what that scripture could pertain to me at this very moment on July 17, 2021. It's extraordinary what's going on, and they're not going backwards. They're not going backwards. To me, they're full steam ahead. I notice they've inflicted it now on Melbourne. I saw a news story there last night where all Victoria, by the looks, are in it. And I saw a news story there last night where the Queensland Premier was in Estimates Committee or something. I put it up, where she just burst out laughing. She could not stop laughing. She couldn't stop. She just couldn't help herself. A laughing fit, they were calling it. And I was saying to Mum, like, they're all corrupt, right? All these politicians are corrupt. And I was saying to Mum yesterday that I remember when the Queensland floods happened. So I was living in Queensland. I was actually in Manila at the time, but I was living in Queensland at the time of the floods. I was in Manila for 6 months, and the floods happened while I was over there. So I was based in Brisbane at the time. And I remember Anna Bligh, the Queensland Premier back then, they're all in on it, right? But she seemed to me to show some genuine emotion. She was physically, she was shedding tears because it was horrible, those Queensland floods. It was absolutely brutal. And so much devastation, so much death, and so people just lost everything. So many heartbreaking stories. And she was physically distressed. And I would have thought, if we're in this, what they're saying right now, if it was true, you would have a New South Wales Premier and an Australian Prime Minister who are just bursting at the seams with sadness for their people. But I'm not seeing it. I'm not seeing 1 ounce of sadness. They come out and they say, it's with a heavy heart that I say this today, and it's just pure nonsense. And we know it's pure nonsense, right? And I'm not seeing one emotion that indicates to me that they're at all distressed. It's like they've been prepared for it. They're all handling it so well. They're all handling it so well. I even look at that Winston Churchill, right? Obvious Freemason, obviously in on it. But the role he played in World War II is that he stirred that nation to arms. He stirred those people, right? It's true. That's what happened to me. That's what I see, that he stirred that nation. He stirred them with emotion. And they followed him. I'm not seeing it here now. I'm just seeing brutal dictators who are just inflicting rules, and there's not one piece of empathy, and there's not one piece of sadness in their souls. And you can see it. You'll know them by their fruits, right? You'll know them by their fruits. So I'm laying low. That's my plan right now, is I'm laying low, and so far it's working, and I feel a good amount of peace. I feel good. I feel really, really good. I had the most amazing prayer this morning, and we're feeling good. I say to the Holy Spirit, I feel like I've got some clear air. Now, this is the other thing I want to say, and to him goes all the glory for that. How can you have clear air in this environment now? I do. I feel good. I feel blessed. It's very windy here. It's very, very windy. So I live in an old place here, and yesterday parts of my roof started to fall off. So you probably hear a lot of noise in the background, and that's my roof creaking. And I've got a man coming today apparently to look at my roof. So I might have men walking on my roof, but I'm hoping that I won't be recording by then. But they're due now, so they could come at any time, right? So you can hear my roof creaking, and it's not fun here right now. It's like I feel my roof could actually blow off at any moment. So that's the noise that you potentially hear in the background, and it's extremely windy. It's not pleasant out there at all. Now, this is what happened at Mum's yesterday. So this fella here, Adam Crouch MP, the member for Terrigal, right? So he's a local member of parliament. Now, and that's state government. Here in Australia, we've got three levels of government. One just ain't enough, right? We've got local government, the council, and we've got the state government, and then we've got the federal government. And it's Gladys is the premier. So this is this guy. He's the local member for Terrigal, which is not where I am, but it's very close. Now, He released this. You can see here, like, they're all part of it, right? They're all part of it. You can see here with the orange. Orange, I believe, is the only number that adds up to 33 in numerology. For me, orange is a real colour to look for. Like, orange is not a colour people should be wearing in this role, I don't think. I don't think it looks at all good for a man to be wearing an orange tie. I think ties are ridiculous. I just think they're a choke around people's neck. The person that ever invented the tie should I don't understand ties. I've never understand ties and suits, and you can probably see by the way I dress that I dress to be comfortable. But you can see straight away that for me, they're in on it, right? He's a local MP, he's a politician, he's in on it. Now, Mum brought this to my attention yesterday, so you can see, and it's Facebook, right? So I can see this. I don't have Facebook. You see, I have to log in, but I can see this page. So I can see this page, right? So this is his Facebook page, and you can see here that he's pushing the rugby league, he's pushing the football, and he's, you know, decked out in a face mask, and he doesn't need to wear a face mask here, but he needs to wear a face mask here. It's all just ridiculous, all the contradictions, right? Now, he released this notification on the 13th of July. If the risk subsides and if we record no local cases over the next few days, I will fiercely advocate for the New South Wales Health to end the Central Coast's lockdown, right? So this was the 13th. Now, when I put down that my video to the scattered strangers greetings, my Mark of the Beast video, it was around that time. And I said on that video that there's been no local cases, but there are now, right? The Central Coast, I'll put it up on screen now, the Central Coast now have cases. But when he did this post, there was no cases, right? I support the Premier's lockdown decision because she has followed the health advice to the letter. Of course you do, right? Because you're not in it for the people, you're in it for your masters. While following the health advice, and we should be their masters because they're the servant, they're the public servant, but no. They're our masters on the earth. While following the health advice is our number one priority, your people should be, I am acutely aware of the impact this lockdown is having on our families, workers, and businesses. So if you were acutely aware of that, your priority would be them, not the health advice. But you're not acutely aware because you don't care. Current New South Wales Health remains very concerned about a seeding event occurring on the New South Wales Central Coast region. Not sure what that seeding means. I haven't looked at that. However, if this risk does not subside and if we record no local cases over the next few days, I will fiercely advocate for the Premier and Creature Chant to end the to carry. If we take this very seriously, right? That's her.
If we all take this very seriously.
Her that can't even clean her teeth properly. And to end the Central Coast, she's the health officer and she's got brown teeth, right? She's got brown teeth. And they just look horrendous. She just looks like she's got the most unhealthy mouth, and she's the health officer, and that's who we're taking our health advice here from the on the New South Wales Central Coast. Kerry, if we take this very seriously, Chan.
If we all take this very
We
seriously.
do not want the lockdown to go one day longer than's necessary, but if that was true, it wouldn't have gone for one day. That is why everyone must continue to stay at home and follow the rules, right? Because the rules are your number one priority. Not your constituents, right? So it's full of contradictions. They're full of contradictions and they're full of hot air, but that's what he said, right? So I went to Mum's and Mum pointed this out. So my mother's waking up. It's marvelous. It's a wonderful thing. She's waking up and she's fully aware of this. She knows what's going on, right? And she just looked at me and she said, "Go and have a look at the front page of the local paper, son." So Mum's the only person that reads the Central Coast Chronicle. Nobody reads it, right? So this is dated the 14th of July, 2021. So we come back to this bloke's post, and he posts on the 13th, right? And there was no cases then. There were no cases on the Central Coast then, and he said, "We are going to go and fiercely advocate that the Central Coast ends the lockdown, right? The lockdown ends for the Central Coast. We're going to fiercely advocate." This member of parliament, who's the rules are his main priority, not his constituents, the rules and the health advice. That's his priority, not his constituents, right? So he posts this on the 13th. This comes out on the 14th. Whoa! Put everything on hold. It's been detected. The boogie. The boogie's in the sewerage. It's in the sewerage. So they've detected the boogie in the sewerage. So look out, hold the presses, New South Wales, the New South Wales Central Coast. It must continue. Must continue. Presto! Presto! There it is. There it is. So, No need. There's no need now for Adam Crouch MP to go and lobby for his constituents. There's no need because we've got the boogie in the sewage. It's just so... It's sickening. It's absolutely sickening to watch. And they're... It's in the sewage. They can detect it in the sewage? Are you serious? They're going to put it in the water next. I can feel it. They're going to say it's in the water, and that's going to be the next test. Are they going to turn off the water to say it's unsafe? I can see it. I can feel it. They're going to say it's in the water. I can see it. It's just so dark here, man. It's so, so dark. So that's me right now, right? So what do you do? What do you do? You just wait patiently. You just wait patiently on the Lord, and that's what I'm doing. I'm just laying low, and I just want to get through this and do my 10 pages a day, continue to do my videos, and get to know the Holy Spirit more and more, and just grow in this glorious gospel. And it's just heightening just my sense that we are in some extraordinary events here, and the fact that I've been led to these scriptures in Revelation, and I'm indeed starting to get, I feel like I'm starting to get some more understanding in them. And the plan is to have a look at the first resurrection and these scriptures in Revelation. That's the plan for the next little bit on this video. So to be led here right now to be talking about these things, not because I want to be right, not because I want to understand. It's where the Holy Spirit's led me because of my videos and my testimony. It's a glorious thing. So I'm learning more about the mark of the beast and who's not going to take them, and whoever I'm blessed enough to have watched these videos, we're all going to learn together. Isn't it a wonderful thing? Isn't it a wonderful thing as I endure this, what they call a lockdown? He's amazing. He is an amazing God, the Holy Spirit. So,
heaven and earth will disappear, but my words remain forever. But no one knows the date and hour when the end will be, not even the angels, no, nor even God's Son. Only the Father knows. The world will be at ease, banquets and parties and weddings, just as it was in Noah's time before the sudden coming of the flood. People wouldn't believe what was going to happen until the flood actually arrived and took them all away. So shall my coming be. Two men will be working together in the field, and one will be taken, the other left. Two women will be going about their household tasks, one will be taken, the other left. So be prepared, for you don't know what day your Lord is coming.
Life was filled with guns and war, and everyone got trampled on the floor. I wish we'd all been ready. Children died, the days grew cold. A piece of bread could buy a bag of gold. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind. The sun has come, you've been left behind. A man and wife are sleeping there. She hears a noise. We'd all been ready. Two men walking up a hill, one disappears and one's left standing still. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind. The sun has come, you've been left behind. Guns and war, and everyone got trampled on the floor. I wish we'd all been ready. Children died, create.